In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Welcome to St. George's Parish and to this Mass for Monday of the sixth week of Easter. As we prepare to celebrate the mystery of Christ's love, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for his pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd. You call by name those who are yours, and you lead them in right paths for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the door. Those who enter by you will be saved. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. God our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his continual presence in us he may raise us to eternal joy. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. We set sail from Troas and took a straight course to Samothrace, the following day to Neapolis, and from there to Philippi, which is a leading city of the district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We remained in this city for some days. On the Sabbath day we went outside the gate by the river, where we supposed there was a place of prayer, and we sat down and spoke to the woman who had gathered there, to the women who had gathered there. A certain woman named Lydia, a worshipper of God, was listening to us. She was from the city of Thyatira and a dealer in purple cloth. The Lord opened her heart to listen eagerly to what was said by Paul. When she and her household were baptized, she urged us, saying, "If you have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come and stay at my home." And she prevailed upon us. The response to Psalm 149, Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Let Israel rejoice in their Maker, let the children of Zion be joyful in their King. Let them praise his name in the dance, let them sing praise to him with timbrel and lyre.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
For the Lord has pleasure in his people and adorns the poor with salvation. Let the faithful be joyful in glory, let them rejoice in their ranks.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Says the Lord, and the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am alive for evermore.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You also are to testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have said these things to you to keep you from stumbling. They will put you out of the synagogues. Indeed, the hour is coming when those who kill you will think that by doing so they are offering worship to God. And they will do this because they have not known the Father nor me. But I have said these things to you so that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told you about them. I did not say these things to you from the beginning, because I was still with you." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For the people of God. for the Holy Church, for God's Holy Church throughout the world, for our bishops Robert and David, for Peter, our new archdeacon. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For God's holy people in this place, that in the world of work they may be light in the darkness and salt to add savour. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, for the people of Tigray and Ethiopia, for those whose lives are blighted by violence, economic instability. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who are sick and who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Especially we pray for those in intensive care, those who suffer from COVID, those who are struggling to recover. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who have died in the faith of Christ, for those whose faith is known to God alone, for those who cannot recognize the love of God made visible in the face of Christ our Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
In a moment's silence, let us bring our own prayers to our Heavenly Father. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
The risen Christ came and stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." And they were glad when they saw the Lord. May the peace of the risen Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, it is our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, almighty and eternal Father. And in these days of Easter to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of all your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory.
Holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of power and might,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, of St. George, St. Genevieve, and of all your saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
We pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
God's holy gifts for God's holy people.
Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is his Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Let us pray. God our Father, whose Son Jesus Christ gives the water of eternal life, may we thirst for you, the spring of life and the source of all goodness, through him who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God the Father, by whose glory Christ was raised from the dead, strengthen you to walk with him in his risen life. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.